Hey guys, it's Kelsey and I'm back with another How to Kill a Kit with Style layout. So this one is for paper issues. This is for the Summer Lovin' Challenge, just to scrap something summery. It is for a Hawaii page, which we went in spring, but it's still very summery themed to me, I feel like, so I'm counting it. I'm just using some of the scraps I have left. I'm really getting down in this paper pad now, so I'm really just trying to struggle to finish full pages using what I have left. I did really want to get this big pineapple paper used up because I just cannot, I'm having issues with this pattern, so I am not even going to gut this one. It's going to be a large frame around the rest of the layout. I'm going to put a big chunk of this pink in the center and start my layout from there, but that way I get this pineapple paper used up because I don't want it left over. I'd rather just use it all as a background even though I'm not gutting it and, you know, have it on a page. So you did just see me at first gut that pink paper. I gutted it from the center out. That way I had a leftover frame to use on a later page because I only have one full 12 by 12 by the end of this layout. So having that pink frame will go on that last page with that last layout. So that is my goal. And now I'm just plonking all of the scraps I have on the page in some kind of way. I'm not thinking too hard about it. I'm just layering them kind of how they are and seeing what I like. I kind of like how they're set up now, so I'm just gonna start gluing. This one came together super, super quick. It took me just, I think, 32 minutes from start to finish. So my layouts do get a lot quicker towards the end of the kits because you only have so much to work with, so there's not a whole lot of thinking. It's just kind of plonking the scraps down, using what you have, which is a really enjoyable process for me. I will be really happy when this layout or this kit is done. Doing 2 months worth with one paper pad is a lot. So thank you everyone for sticking with me because I know it's a lot of this collection. So, which has been a lot of fun. I'll be really excited when I can look back at everything and see what I made. But oh my gosh, I will be ready to move on by the time I am done with this collection. So as you can see, I'm just kind of zigzagging these scraps around, layering them wherever they look good, making sure that any gaps that I use when I stretch these papers across are covered by other papers. So that's what I'm doing there with that green polka dot. And then, of course, that flamingo I also cut to stretch to the other side to look like a larger piece. So I'm just trying to build up a little section here. I'm kind of doing a semi-L design. I started out with some more vertical scraps, and then I built out horizontally, and now I'm just trying to round it off to look like there's enough layers that I'm happy with. So you can see my scrap pile to the left there. That's pretty much all I have left other than the full 12 by 12, the only 12 by 12 I have left. So that kind of gives you a reference point for what I have to work with and why I'm pulling what I'm pulling into this page. The last couple pages, I think you've noticed the patterns are all a little mismatchy because it is what it is. I'm at the end of the paper pad. I want to use them all together. So even though if I was in the beginning of this paper pad, I may not have put these patterns together, they're getting on the page now because I don't want things left over. I don't want scraps to go in the bin. I'd rather just use them all up on the page. They're from the same collection. It'll work out, I'm hoping. So I'm tucking a scrap of doily in. I wanted to round off a little area here to start building. I'm pulling in my very last flamingo, I think, from all of the ephemera packs that I started with, which is impressive because I had a lot. And this little flamingo is from the On Trend 2 collection, I think. Yes. So that is the flamingo that has some gold on it, unlike the flamingos from the Palm Beach collection. I'm just tucking a little green tag next to it to start a little cluster. I am pulling in some gold and white twine into that tag, and that's just going to start a little area there. I figure I might just put my title there. I'm not thinking I really need to do too much journaling. I kind of just want to embellish a little bit once I kind of get all these layers settled. And again, I'm going to pull in that thicker sheet with all the bright, colorful, puffy stickers. I've really liked using that with this collection ever since I got it, so I'll pull that in again. You can see there my puffy sticker sheet I am pulling in. I'm getting it used up, you guys. I think, hopefully you're proud of me, because I think I used up every single puffy sticker. So I got three on here, one in three separate areas, and then there was only one left, and it was a little green circle puffy sticker that said beach on it. So I went back to the, you would have seen it in in the beginning of the month, where I use that big Dear Lizzie heartwood veneer. It's a very monochromatic green and gold layout. I ended up going back and sticking that last puppy sticker on that page. So all my puppy stickers are used up, and I'm really proud of myself because for the longest time they were not getting used up, and it was making me sad because I don't want them to be stuck in my stash forever. I wanted to get them on pages, and so I'm really happy that I did. So got those three on here, and now I'm back to these puffy stickers. These are so fun for summery, beachy, tropical layouts, and I just thought it was going so great. I have this purple shirt here, so I went ahead and decided to pull in this puffy smile and use that as my title, and then there's some other pinky purple embellishments I decided to pull in just to kind of tie my purple tank top and my title with the other pinks in the page, particularly this hot pink background. So that made me happy. I just used one that says selfie time and another one says treasure this. This is a selfie I took on our rainforest tour in Maui, so that was really cool. That's on the road to Hana. So I wanted to document that. I know you guys have seen me doing a lot of selfie pictures lately. I don't know why. I think I just got a clump of them in my Hawaii stack, but I didn't just take selfies. Most of them are not pictures of me. So I know you're seeing a lot of them kind of all in a row. So I'm sorry about all the selfie pictures, but here are the close-ups. Again, this was a super easy one, just using up my scraps. So super satisfying. Thanks guys for watching. Bye.